front of 20,000 fans, packed with celebrities and fight fans. What a night. A great stage for Bonario to give us his best performance.
13 is a tall lightweight. We rarely see people out kind of, you know, height advantage on Bonario, but Jartine is big. Bonario's pressing Jartine up against the cage now. Again, I asked him, I was like, what do you want to showcase here tonight? What are you looking for in front of your crowd here in Manila? And he was like, I want another submission win. So he's calling his shot, saying he wants to take Jartine down and finish him on the floor. And that's kind of exactly what he's doing. Dropping down, changing levels. Jartine goes for the ride. Bonario gets into side control.
He seems so much stronger at lightweight, Bonario.
Oh yeah, this is one of the individuals that the weight cutting.
Yeah, really benefited, yeah.
Extreme, like we're seeing an entirely new Bonario as he's not able, because he doesn't have to worry about the massive weight cut. And he walks around at 79 kilos.
He can concentrate on his conditioning at a comfortable weight, at a strong weight. And that's what we've seen from him in the last year or so.
Yeah, he says he has to diet down so he can't eat as much, but he has to lose a little bit of body fat to make the weight. And without the weight cutting, without the water restriction, he's a completely different athlete.
Just one of so many world champions in the arena tonight. Honorio Bonario, the former featherweight title holder. Edward Falayan's coming up. Angela Lee's here. Brandon Vera's here. Rich Franklin's here. Manny Pacquiao's here.
Match up.
Nice transition from Jartine. Bonario tried to go knee on belly. He was thinking about, Jartine started to turn. He was thinking about taking the back, but Jartine was able to out kind of maneuver Bonario and end up on top here.
Approaching the halfway mark, opening round. Bonario takes a cuffing right hand. He gets up and spins his man around and knees him to the hip. Sends in a right hand to the side of Jartine's body. Thump to the upper thigh.
It all counts.
They all do. Don't see many of those, though.
It all counts. A strike is a strike.
Watch out!
Sometimes you're with the shoulder, sometimes it's a punch to the thigh. And they do irritate you. You can set up something. So if you slap somebody on the thigh, you get them thinking about something else. And you can probably transition into something different.
Not happy that there's enough action going on. Throws them to the center of the cage, and they get straight into it.
Bonario goes again for the takedown.
Whoa, took a big up kick from the sole of the foot there from Jartine. And then it made a slapping sound.
And Jartine goes for a takedown of his own. Very well done. Slid right under the punch, got the double leg. Now puts Bonario on his back. Bonario able to stand back up, press Jartine up against the cage. He's got two underhooks now. So he's going to be able to get a little bit better body control. He's got that head pressed up against the cage there.
Back into the center of the cage, Honorio Bonario, and then gets pushed back across the cage. Hand around Bonario's leg, and you can see the height difference.
See, this clinch fighting is such a strategic game. You know, you've got to make sure you get your head in the right position, that head pressing up against Jartine. See how he's got his head underneath the chin of Jartine? Opens up, keeps the head high so he can slide an elbow right in there. Brandon Vera liked that one quite a bit.
Just looking at them there, they really have made another slapping sound, didn't it? There it is, that forearm again.
That's exactly what he needs to do when he gets this cage position. Keep the head open, open him up, drop in these strikes.
style has changed fairly significantly in recent times. We talked about the weight difference and how he is stronger, but Team Lakai as a whole have improved their grappling games, specifically their takedown defense.
But now you would almost think that Benario was naturally a wrestler and a grappler. Big head kick there, just barely misses Benario, slid underneath it. And again, he goes right in for the takedown. This is definitely something that we're not used to seeing. Benario consistently shooting for takedowns and not throwing those heavy hands and kick strikes.
A lot of Filipinos who get into the fight game started off just messing around with something that I think they call buton, which is a form of wrestling. And that is where Benario started. Kevin Beling on as well, very much had that kind of a background before being schooled in Wushu and transforming their activities to a striking-based martial art.
Here he is in the half guard of Jardim. So he's gonna wanna try to pop that leg out. He's got the right leg inside the half guard of Jardim, so he's gonna wanna just slide that knee out, pass into side control. Jardim's doing the right thing by turning onto his side so he's not lying flat onto his back. Good reversal by Jardim to end up on top.
It's a great effort from the Czech fighter.
Benario just stands right back up. Throws Jardim up against the cage.
That's the strength of Benario. Oh, left hand! Knocks him flat on his back! And with one punch, Benario extends his winning streak to four. That was a blistering finish.
Immediately got some separation and threw a bomb of a left hook. Brandon Barrett-Takas threw that one.
You know, that was textbook counter to a Muay Thai kick. Benario ate a tie kick to the ribs, countered right away, loaded up, same side, and pulled that left hook, hit him right on the chin and laid him out flat on his back. Here's the replay, kick, hook, straight, hook, lay him down. That is textbook Muay Thai counters. Eat the kick, load up, throw that hook.
Oh, what a hook!
You can't teach it any better than Benario executes right here. Even ends with he starts with a straight after the kick and follows up with the hook. Amazing job. Team Lakai putting in work.
Dude, you said it. Team Lakai. They just go on and on and on, don't they?
They don't stop. Iron sharpens iron.
Ladies and gentlemen, to present the medal for this fight, we have Jeff Andres, property president of City of Dreams Manila, and the City of Dream guest, Ring Girls. And now, folks, your referee, Yuji Shimada, has put a